Hey, what is going on, guys? What's happening, YouTube? You have tuned into Rules for Rebels, and today is episode 95 of Side Hustle Tuesdays, part of our weekly side hustling series. I apologize, I missed last week, so I wanted to make sure I got this week done. I'm actually kind of surprised that I was able to crank out an episode this week. This week, I'm actually going through this investing, kind of stock trading course. It's about 8 hours a day with 2 hours of, you know, at-home study and videos to watch every evening. So really, really intensive. It's really, really interesting stuff. We finally started trading today. Was trading on a demo account, and I actually made $1,500 today trading on a demo account. I'm not going to deny a lot of it was probably luck, but things are kind of starting to come together. It's a really kind of interesting strategy that they're teaching. I don't feel I'm really equipped to kind of teach it yet, but if after some practice and stuff I'm able to get this down, if you guys have an interest, I'd be happy to make a video and kind of share that with you. But let's, without further ado, get into today's episode. So today's episode is a story about a business analyst who created an affiliate marketing side hustle on the periphery of the marijuana industry. And to date, his project is bringing in about $1,200 a month, which isn't too shabby, especially considering A, how cheap this side hustle was to start, and B, how little content he actually has on his site. If you check out his site, there's really not that many articles. The articles aren't really long form articles. I'm pretty sure he hired VAs to write these articles. So you know, I'm not trying to talk crap about his project, but the point is, this isn't a huge bar. Like, I feel like most of you guys could get something similar going within a couple of weeks. Now, we've covered a number of marijuana side hustle stories here on Side Hustle Tuesdays. We had the BYOC, or the Bring Your Own Cannabis painting class out of California. We had the Colorado bartender a few months back who created the weed guidebook for travelers. And I think there's even been a few more weed stories that we've covered, but the rest of them are slipping my mind. So maybe I should lay off the wacky tobacco myself. One thing, though, that a lot of these stories have in common is none of them are actually selling marijuana itself. They're all working kind of in the periphery of the industry or the niche. One interesting piece of news, and potentially an opportunity for any of you guys in the Midwest, within the past week, actually it was on December 6th to be exact, Michigan became the first Midwest state to legalize marijuana. Well, retail stores won't be approved and up and running until nearly 2020. Yeah, sucks, I know. There should be a lot of opportunities to start businesses and make money around the space, whether it be starting a delivery business, setting up a shop, selling lights. You know, there's all types of ways to sell shovels and pickaxes, as they say, without actually being involved in the industry. Now, one thing I'm personally going to be very curious to see with this Michigan marijuana legalization is if any clever entrepreneurs find a way around current laws. I know Washington, D.C. had a similar goofed up system where weed was legal, but there was nowhere you could legally buy it. And what some clever entrepreneurs did, they started selling t-shirts and other kind of knickknacks and items and giving away free weed with the purchase of a t-shirt. So, for example, you buy a $60 weed t-shirt and you get a free eighth with it. You didn't actually buy weed, you bought a t-shirt, and that's kind of one way that they kind of skirted the law. So it'll be interesting to see if any creative entrepreneurs really kind of dig into the law and find a way to legally sell marijuana while still staying within state laws. Anyhow, getting into today's story, today's side hustle story is about Stone Everett. Stone Everett is a business analyst from Orlando, Florida. Stone has always been entrepreneurial and always had a side project going. None of his ideas ever really took off and became huge, but most of them would make him some pocket money until he either lost interest and moved on to something else, or until the idea or trend became dated and kind of just stopped making money. One of his best ones, and kind of the basis of today's side hustle story, is he taught himself how to make WordPress websites by watching YouTube videos. He freelanced a bit building websites for other people, but he also made some niche sites and did some affiliate marketing for himself as well. Stone knew cannabis or weed was a big niche and a popular thing. He didn't want to sell the cannabis himself. It required too much money. The regulations seemed intimidating. So he decided to sell items and accessories around the space by using other vendors, which is essentially affiliate marketing. As far as challenges that he's faced, Stone says one of his biggest challenges is figuring out which items to sell and which affiliates to work with. Not only does he have to find items that are in demand and that people will click his links and buy, but he also has to choose affiliate companies who he can trust enough that customers will follow through and purchase, and ones which he can reliably know will actually pay him out his commissions, which are due. Stone says he tries to pick a diverse number of items that appeal to different types of people, and if you look at his site, you can see that. He has an affiliate link to a seed store for those people looking to grow weed. He has an affiliate link to Tommy Chong's CBD store. He has another affiliate link to a pet store selling pet CBD items. And he also has links to sites that sell paraphernalia like grinders, bongs, pipes, dugouts, etc. One mildly interesting thing about his site, and something I personally probably wouldn't do, is he kind of seemingly tries to come off as if he's the one selling these items. He actually has an FAQ/contact page where he answers questions about payment options. So he says PayPal and most credit cards are accepted. He answers questions about how items ship. But his answers are kind of vague, and he never really clearly communicates that when you're buying something from quote-unquote him, you're actually not buying something from him. You're buying something from the 4 to 6 to maybe 8 different sellers, whether it be Grass City, Tommy Chong, Crop King Seeds, etc. Now, the way he has his site set up is his FAQ is right next to the contact button, which to me encourages people to contact him for tracking info or order questions. However, if they were to contact him, he's not going to have any information about your order because he's not actually the seller of record. So to me, that's something I probably wouldn't do, but you know, it's his shop. He can do it how he wants. I'm guessing maybe he gets more conversions acting as if he's the actual seller as opposed to an affiliate. So maybe that's why he does it. Another challenge Stone faces is advertising, marketing, and driving traffic. Most mainstream advertising platforms, be it Facebook ads, AdWords, etc., they don't allow marijuana-related ads. So for the traffic he relies on SEO, which is search engine optimization, or organic social media traffic, because he can't use social media ads, right? He can't use Facebook ads. He can't use Instagram ads. He can't use Pinterest ads. He might be able to get away with Reddit ads, but generally most ads are going to be shut down to him. If he happens to be watching this, one solution he may look to, there's a website called smoke.io. It's kind of like a Steemit, but for weed content. And they actually recently started working with an advertising network specifically devoted to cannabis and marijuana items. Their long-term plan is actually to create their own ad network that's going to run on the blockchain and that people can actually use these smoke tokens to buy advertising. But until they get that up and running, I forget the name of the network, but they're working with an ad network. So that may be something to look into, Stone. Moving on, at times, Stone has struggled to balance his full-time job, his personal life, and the business. But this side hustle already is bringing in $1,200 a month in profits, which is about a quarter of what he makes at his full-time job. So he's hoping to scale it up and hoping to someday down the road maybe be able to leave his full-time job. One smart thing about how Stone is running his business is he's doing the affiliate model as we discussed. While he's not selling weed, even some products like bongs, paraphernalia, seeds can be a murky area. If you remember just a few years back, Tommy Chong actually went to jail for this very thing, for selling bongs online. You know, certain states may have different rules. There may be some other rules with selling it across state lines. It's still federally illegal, so obviously if you're using the postal service, that could present problems. So by not actually selling these items himself and just forwarding potential customers to these shops, he doesn't have to deal with any of that legislation or legal, you know, any of the legal issues or any potential legal problems. One challenge that this presents, however, is he likely has a very low time customer lifetime value. And what I mean by that is if you happen to stumble upon Stone's website, you click a link to a CBD site and you buy some CBD products, if you wind up liking them and a couple weeks later want to come back and buy more, it's not very likely that you're going to go to Stone's affiliate site and click the link to go to the CBD shop. You're probably just going to go to the CBD shop. So Stone's likely only to get somebody, a customer as a one-time customer or one-time purchaser. In the future, if they choose to continue using that business, they're likely to just sidestep him and go direct to the company. So that's the one downside of his business. Overall, though, for the ease and low cost of setting up this type of business, it's really a winning situation. One other thing I just wanted to add about this. So the content on his, I think his site looks nice. The content is nice. But just to make you guys realize kind of like how easy this would be for some of you guys to do, like the articles he's writing, it's not great journalism, right? It's like I shared a story with you guys yesterday about the former eBay rep who enlisted his eBay coworkers and started like a darknet drug ring. That article, I'm not actually talking about that guy, but the article that was written, right? That was like a really long form article, very well written, very well researched. You can tell the articles on Stone's website, you can tell they're kind of written by VAs. You know, they're things like, here's seven marijuana industry businesses you can start for under $1,000, or here's the best grind. It's kind of low bar content, it's short content, it's not amazing journalism. So any of you guys could probably write articles like this yourself, or even hire a VA to do it for you. So this is a business model that you guys could replicate, whether you wanted to start like a marijuana related affiliate business like Stone did, or if you wanted to kind of take his overall business model but twist it and do it for some other niche, whether it be paddleboarding or video games or whatever else. Anyhow, best of luck to Stone in continuing to grow his business. That's all I got for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed Stone's story. I hope you were inspired. And until next time, this is Rules for Rebels and Side Hustle Tuesdays signing out. Later, guys.